Hey everyone! Greetings back here from Brno, here in the Czech Republic. So for today's video, I am kind of inspired because for the past few weeks, I've had many discussions about Czech and Moravian wine, what grapes are local to here, what are the specialties of the region, and for me, I kept circling back to one grape variety in particular, and this is Cabernet Moravia. And so today's video, I want to showcase two Cabernet Moravias from very different producers, different styles, same kind of sub-region. But I wanted to show them because this is a grape for me that is 100% Moravian. It even has Moravia in the name. It doesn't get more Moravian than that. So Cabernet Moravia is a grape variety that's a crossing. It's a crossing of Cabernet Franc and Zweigelt. It was crossed in 1975 in Moravská Nová Ves, small wine growing village south of Brno. And it was created with intention. So Cabernet Moravia was created to make a red grape variety that's fairly frost resistant, that's resistant to botrytis, that would grow well in the warmer growing climates, particularly in Velké Pavlovice. So Cabernet Moravia was first registered in the Czech National Grape Registry in 2001. And since then, plantings have increased slightly. Right now, it sits at about 200 hectares primarily in South Moravia. And for me, it is the perfect fall wine. So look no further. You do not have to spend a fortune on Pinot Noir this fall. You can pick up a delicious local Cabernet Moravia and it will do the job. So for me, in terms of red wine, my styles are high acid, low tannin, and just elegant, nice black fruit, red fruit, some herbal tones. And for me, Cabernet Moravia just checks every box. So the grape variety, as I mentioned, is the offspring of Cabernet Franc and Zweigelt. So to unpack Cabernet Moravia, I think it's important to understand where the grape comes from. So Cabernet Franc is also the parent of Cabernet Sauvignon, in fact. Cabernet Franc is a quite old grape variety. And for me, some of the best expressions come from the Loire Valley, particularly from Saumur and Anjou. So Cabernet Franc, typically, in terms of its typicity and its varietal characteristics, Cabernet Franc is lightly black-fruited, sometimes red-fruited, about medium-bodied, really nice structured tannins. These wines are not uber-powerful. They're not hit you over the head like 15% Shiraz or 15% Mourvèdre. You're looking at a medium-bodied, generally 13% alcohol style of wine. What I love about Cabernet Franc, though, is that you get this slight herbal note to it, too, kind of dried sage, dried thyme, very, very complex styles of wine. And by crossing Cabernet Franc with Zweigelt, which in and of itself is a crossing too. Zweigelt was developed as a crossing of St. Laurent and Blaufränkisch in Austria in the early 20th century. Zweigelt's very peppery and shows notes of sour cherry and cranberry. And by crossing this kind of peppery red-fruited Zweigelt with the herbal, black-fruited, elegant, really refined tannin structure of Cabernet Franc, you have Cabernet Moravia. So for me, it really combines the best of both worlds, and Cabernet Moravia can have a wide range of flavors in the wines that are produced from the grape. So black and red fruit, dried herbs, typically light to medium bodied, generally a touch higher acidity, but for me, for fall, there is no other wine that can compete. Food pairings for Cabernet Moravia. Think about all the things that come in the fall, like all the root vegetables and squash and pumpkins and roast goose and duck and some of the game that's coming out now. Hunting season has started. So all of these incredible local ingredients with a local wine from local producers, it doesn't get better than that. So to start, for today's wine video, I'm showing two Cabernet Moravias, both from Velké Pavlovice, but from very different producers, different styles, and different expressions of the grape. Starting off today, I'm excited to talk about Roman Fabig's Cabernet Moravia. This is his 2017 vintage. Roman Fabig is a young winemaker based in Hustopeche. His wine sits at 12% alcohol. There's less than half a gram of residual sugar in this wine, so this wine is very dry, and about 5 grams of acidity. Now, talking a little bit about Roman, so I had the great pleasure to actually visit his winery a few weeks ago, and it is truly a minimalist style winery and tasting room. One thing that is quite remarkable about Roman's winery and operations is that it is the cleanest winery I've ever walked into before. It was so clean, I really wanted to take off my shoes. I have never been to a facility that clean before, and I certainly told him that, I mean, you could literally eat food off the floor. I mean, I've been to a lot of cellars. I've been to a lot of wineries all around the world. His was certainly the cleanest, and I highly respect that. Hygiene is king in terms of winemaking, and that just leads me to understand that, you know, Roman's wines will always be fault-free, and so I highly respect and admire that side of his attention to detail. So regarding his Cabernet Moravia, this is the only red grape that he has. So Roman primarily specializes in Sauvignon Blanc. That is his baby. That is what he wants to focus his attention on. But I'm so happy he does a Cabernet Moravia too, because this region is really perfect for it. It's a very warm climate. And so Cabernet Moravia is a late ripening grape, really needs that long hang time, needs that extra bit of sun, extra warmth in the vineyards. And so with his Cabernet Moravia, it goes through quite a long fermentation process. It's a 7-week fermentation. And then that wine goes into lightly toasted oak barrels to get a little bit more structure, a little bit more body to it. But yeah, Roman, in fact, was one of the first, I believe the only Czech winemakers to ever be rated by Robert Parker. So July 2020, Robert Parker scored his Sauvignon Blancs with 88 and 89 points. So thumbs up, his wines are fantastic, and I'm so excited to have the opportunity to show his Cabernet Moravia today on my video. So getting right into his wine, this is a light ruby color, a slight medium core, but fairly light in terms of its color, very reminiscent of kind of a Schiava color, or even a really pale Pinot Noir. And the nose shows this really fragrant red fruit, kind of crushed raspberries and sour cherry. But there's this really clean kind of herbal note throughout on the nose, kind of like eucalyptus and mint. Slight hints of sage as well. But very dominant red fruit, but very fragrant as well. Very light bodied on the palate, light to medium bodied, really, really fine tannins, but really pleasant, plump, juicy acidity. Lots of red fruit, red plums on the palate, a dark cherry as well. That little bit of oak helps to give it that structure, that little bit of tannin it really needs to boost it up and make it a more gastronomic wine, more for food pairings. Like I mentioned, fruit, vegetables, and some fowl and game that's coming out this season. But just very refreshing and juicy, and it just makes you salivate. It makes you want to eat something. But this is a really gorgeous fall wine. For me, it just shows the perfect marriage between Cab Franc and Zweigelt. That little hint of dried herbs, a little bit of pepperiness on the finish, and that sour cherry note's really dominant. So beautiful wine from Roman Fabik. I'm so excited to have the chance to meet him and to try his fantastic wines and share them all with you. So the next winery I'm going to be showcasing for their Cabernet Moravia, I had the chance to visit earlier in the summer, and I'm so excited to show his wine on video today. So this is Vinarstvi Vykukal from winemakers Zdeněk Vykukal. So his winery is in Hostiradský Rešov, also in Velké Pavlovice, And Zdeněk, you know, makes wine on the side. He has a full-time job. He makes wine as his hobby. He makes between 10 to 15,000 bottles a year, but he puts his heart and soul into the wines. He is also part of the Authentista Moravia Magna, this authentic group of winemakers that focus on making wine in the most traditional way possible, using old oak barrels, using spontaneous fermentation, no additives, chemicals, or synthetic fertilizers in the vineyard. Really attention to this natural wine movement, this minimal intervention wine movement. And I had the great pleasure of meeting him. Luckily, my friend Hedda was there to translate. Thanks, Hedda. Because, you know, my Czech is dobře. It's getting there, but not enough to be able to ask the questions I really want and to get the answers I need. So getting into Zdeněk's Cabernet Moravia today, the wine has quite a different color to Romans. So this is Romans, which has a very light kind of ruby color to it. And then this is Zdeněk Vykukals, which has more of a darker core to it, more of a almost a fuchsia note to it. But comparing the two is always interesting for me. So yes, so Zdeněk has much more of a darker core to it, darker ruby, almost a purple fuchsia hue to it, magenta. But a really gorgeous color, really pops. Now this wine is showing much more of a purple flower note to it, crushed rose. A little bit of a nutmeg note to it, kind of a sweet spice. Again, that sour cherry, that kind of cherry compote note to it. But it's got this crushed gravel note to it, particularly from the Cab Franc, from its parent grape, this crushed graphite note to it, kind of like pencil shavings. And this really dark black plum on the nose. This wine showing much more earthiness, much more of that dried herb note to it, more black fruited black plums on there, as opposed to the kind of red fruited sour cherry on Romans. This is definitely more blackberry, black cassis notes to it, black currant, black plum. Still medium bodied, a little bit more body, a little bit more roundness than Romans. It's showing a little bit more depth on the finish, but both are delicious. I can imagine both with some turkey this Thanksgiving. With Zdeněk Vykukals, he actually matures his wine in older oak barrels for 18 months. So about 9 months longer than Romans with his Cabernet Moravia. A little bit more time in barrel can lead to a little bit more structure. In fact, Zdeněk Vykukals Cabernet Moravia is 2018. A little bit of a warmer vintage, a little bit more ripeness to the fruit as well, but both excellent examples of a grape that's grown here in the region that has Moravia in the name. It does not get more Moravian than that. And I am so excited to have the chance to share my wine knowledge and my anecdotes and experiences here in the region. And I'm excited to keep drinking Moravian wine for the next 2 years. So that being said, ahoy from Brnenol. Cheers to Cabernet Moravia. And I hope everyone has a great weekend with some great Moravian wine. Ahoy.